Hey, ma'am.
Hiya.
If you had to describe, like, the whole experience, how would you do that? So today, I want to talk about my dog, Romeo. When I was planning this video back in January, in my mind, it was going to be very specific. There was going to be black bars, the color would have been desaturated, and there would have been a sad piano in the background. But I had to stop myself, because what I realized was, this isn't a sad story. It's actually a happy story with one sad element. This story begins for as long as I can remember. Me and my brother were the most persistent little kids on the planet, and we really wanted a dog, and we were terrible, terrible at how relentless we were.
My younger brother, how are you?
Do you remember how relentless we were?
Relentless isn't even the word.
So we tried fish and hamsters.
Was it Scruffy?
Scruffy. It was a hamster with a rat tail. I'm pretty sure you got a rat.
He had a hamster tail, but he was the size and looked like a rat. I came home from school and Dad was like, guess what I've got? And I'm thinking, we've got a dog. Because it's cage. And I'm like, oh my God, Dad bought me a black rat.
I remember the fish, yeah. I took a day off school when my fish died.
I know.
It was devastated. Do you remember when we were talking about getting a rabbit?
Yeah, we talked about rabbit. Yeah, I think we tried everything.
But something that I remember doing is I used to go on the care home websites. and then I left the webpage open. Do you remember that?
I do remember that, yeah.
Very much. Oh, it's not subtle at all. Those phone calls were to emphasise how persistently brutal me and my brother were in our pursuit to get a dog. Especially me. I was far worse than he was. So, after years and years of relentless torture, we finally wore my parents down and we got the chance to get a dog. There were rules, though. It had to be a rescue dog. And it couldn't be a big dog because of the space we had at the house. One day I was on the care home website and I saw this little ad for this dog in the corner. His name was Romeo and he was born on Valentine's Day, hence the name. As soon as I saw him, I ran to my parents and I said to them, this is it, this is the one. We called up the care home shortly after. She wasn't going to tell us about this dog because of his past. All we know is that he had a dodgy leg. And it made it hard for him to walk long distances. But that didn't matter. None of that mattered because all we cared about was what happened now. The life that we could give him post any of the traumatic stuff that happened to him in the past. We booked an appointment to go see him. And, well, the rest is kind of history.
I think we knew as soon as we went into that house and saw him barking and jumping around and everything. There was just something about him, wasn't there, really?
Stars shining bright above you. Night breezes seem to whisper, I love you. Birds singing in the sycamore tree. Dream a little dream of me. Say nighty night and kiss me. Just hold me tight and tell me.
Remy, what are you doing?
Stars fading, but I linger on you. Still craving your kiss. I'm longing to linger till dawn, dear. Just saying this. Sweet dreams till sunbeams find you. Sweet dreams that leave a word.
the whole experience, how would you do that?
Character, joy, just that unconditional love you would get, you know, you get from a pet. Well, I know we didn't have him for that, you know, as long as some people have dogs, but I think just that sort of time we did have with him was, you know, you can't take that away, and it's not that long ago that we lost him, and it's, you know, I still feel it, I feel his sort of presence around all the time, you know. Far more positives were brought to this house, weren't they, really? Alright, love.
Birthday next month, mate, you'll be 8. How does that make you feel? You're going to be 8 years old next week. He's speechless. No? See you guys around. Say goodbye. Goodbye.